Yeah. So we are here live at the Joshua Reese weigh-in. Seconds after the weigh-in, obviously they're heavyweights. Obviously they both make weight. But it was electric, it was energetic, it was thousands of fans over here, and it was a great atmosphere, great energy. I see Bill Haney in the house, his son coming off a sensational knockout win. Bill, your son looked amazing. What a knockout.
Reporting.
Reporting. Look at it right over there. Look, he can fight again next week.
Right, right. You see how good he looked? I told you. Elie, what are we talking about, the power?
A long time ago, you said just watch.
And it's just coming.
Knockout of the year type.
It's still coming. It's still coming.
He made him freeze.
Yeah? Yeah. Now, let me ask you. Who are the other knockout candidates that you have up?
Well, Teofimo Lopez had a knockout this year that was really impressive, too. This year?
Is it this year?
The guy you guys fought, same guy.
Mason Menard? I think that was last year, wasn't it?
I don't remember.
Because he did Edis Tally, I think.
Maybe it was last year.
Then, and then he did Magalino.
Okay.
So Mason Menard was last year.
Mason Menard.
So who was this year?
Okay, so that's this year. Do you go with Joshua? Wilder.
I like Wilder. He's a puncher. But Dominic Brazil took the shot, he got up, and he couldn't continue. So I think that's a stoppage. You know what I mean? But like Devin says, you know, when Wilder punches somebody, when he really gets a hold of them, they go out. And I don't think he really got Brazil the way that he normally would.
By the way, Bill, so let's talk about the Wayne for a second really quick. What did it look like to you? It was electric, thousands of fans. They were singing songs. Joshua, of course, made weight. They don't miss weight. They look good.
Right.
Andrews came in heavy, but
you know what I mean? I'm so happy and also so surprised that so many fans came out.
Thousands.
In the UK, thousands. So that's, we look forward to fighting in the UK one day, hopefully.
Now, how is your son being received here since his fight? It's like a... He's being mobbed.
Yeah. Everything's been good, man. Everything's been good.
Ryan Garcia called him out.
Oh, really?
And your son accepted.
That's good. But you know what, though? They've been calling each other out for years. So, you know what I mean? Until the powers that be get together and make the fight, then, you know, it's just talk.
What do you guys do next? Any idea yet? What's on the books? Next fight? Next opponent?
Well, right now, we're waiting for to fight Abdelev. Of course, that's the mandatory. And then we'll wait for the winner of Lomo and Luke Campbell.
Which should be, I think Lomo has the advantage.
Last question. We're pulling for Luke Campbell, so.
Maybe, eh? It's fine boxing. Hopefully. What do you say about Pacquiao Thurman? What's your take on that?
He's working, yeah.
What's up? How you feeling, Jeff? Pacquiao Thurman?
Pacquiao Thurman. I'm going with Thurman.
Why?
I just think that Pacquiao, I saw some things with him and Broner that had he with Thurman. And everybody's counting Thurman out, but that last fight was a tune-up. I'm expecting a more sharper, more better keep Thurman, for sure.
There you have Blaney. Today on stage, your son with all the great fighters, all the great champions. That was very nice.
Right.
But there you have, where is he now? The man of the hour, doing interviews?
Hold on. Reporting.
There you have it, Bill Haney reporting. What's up? How you guys feeling?
Good.
Yeah, just so I can write
up. Okay, cool.
All right, there you have it. From Mark Clark in the house. We're live.
Are we?
I'm going to turn it off. Or we're going to stay live. We're still recording.